Hello everybody, I am Dr. Graziani, a PhD student at Bauru Dental School, University of São Paulo. I'm very proud to present this case report about the surgery-first approach and lingual brace, published in the November 29th issue of the American Journal of Orthodontics.
The title is Retreatment of a Patient, Orthognathic Surgery-First Approach with Customized Lingual Appliance Combined with Mini Plate Cord. People who worked in this page with me were Drs. Moura, Jansson, Henriques, Guimarães, and Nanda. In conventional three-phase orthognathic surgery, there is deterioration of the patient's profile during the orthodontic preparation for surgery, which can cause social and emotional discomfort to the patient. In the surgery-first approach, there is no deterioration of the profile. The patient presenting this case report came to my private practice in Belém, state of Pará, Brazil. He was asking for improvement in his facial aesthetics and had experienced previous compensatory orthodontic treatment, but was not satisfied with the outcome and its instability. The patient had a concave soft tissue profile, increased facial aectoration, and obtuse nasolabial angle. There was insufficient maxillary anterior teeth exposure upon smile, and the mandibular dental midline was shifted to the left.
Intraorally, there was a class 1 molar relationship on the left and a class 3 on the right side with edge-to-edge incisal relationship and dental wear of the maxillary incisals and molar crossbite on the right.
He had a skeletal class 3 malocclusion resulting from maxillar deficiency and a prognathic mandible with accentuated labial chipping of the maxillary incisals and slight lingual chip of the mandibular incisals. The patient plan consisted of the surgery-first approach followed by post-surgical orthodontic treatment with customized lingual appliance and 4 mini plates to distalize the maxillary and mesialize the mandibular teeth. This option was chosen because the patient wanted to quickly improve his facial appearance with an aesthetic orthodontic treatment. 30 days before surgery, hybrid system customized lingual appliance were placed in use in direct bonding. The surgical and orthodontic correction were virtually planned. To obtain the treatment goals, the virtual surgical plan consisted in a left 4-1 osteotomy with 4 mm of maxillary advancement, associated with clockwise rotation of the maxillomandibular complex, lowering the maxilla 2 mm at the incisors, mandibular bilateral sagittal splint osteotomy to set back the mandible in 5 mm and an advancement of 3 mm. The orthodontic biomechanics were performed after the orthognathic surgery to decompensate the maxillary teeth backward and the mandibular teeth forward.
At the end of treatment, after 8 months, there were great improvements in the frontal and profile aesthetics and harmonious smile arc. Bilateral class 1 molar and canine occlusion was obtained, with ideal overjet and overbite and the maxillary and mandibular midlines coincident with the facial midline. Advancement of the maxilla, retrusion of the mandible, clockwise rotation of the maxillomandibular complex, advancement of the chin, and improvement of the maxillary and mandibular incise inclinations can be observed in the cephalometric superimposition. The skeletal and dentovelar chains can also be observed in the 3D superimposition. 1 year post-treatment photographs show excellent stability of the treatment results. The patient was very satisfied with the great facial and smile improvements and with the short treatment time. We would like to thank Dr. Berentes and Ms. Burke for the opportunity to present this video. I hope you enjoyed this case report. For more information, you can read the original article in the AJODO. Thank you for your attention.